Silence is, you know, when I got the album, I wasn't even gonna suggest it to any of y'all. I really wasn't, because I knew that this was not something that was accessible for everyone. Like, this is not your standard hip-hop album. Like, I have a hard time even really calling it a hip-hop album. Like, this is just, I don't know, man. Like, I think that these guys are doing something that's really, really different. And it's not really something that a lot of people are going to appreciate. Because if you're looking at this album from a standard hip-hop perspective, you're not going to fucking understand it. You're going to put it on and be like, what the fuck is up with these beats? What the fuck is up with this dude that's rhyming
that's
off funny?
The album sounds dope, though, with the beats. I think, to me, the beats remind me so much of... And me and Mike, we talked about it, too. I think that's why he recommended to me was... What? What is so funny?
You just Kanye the shit out of me.
I thought you was finished. Your voice was getting low, like
you said. Your voice,
your voice was getting all low and shit. Like, yeah.
He was already talking.
Yeah, low. You know what I'm saying?
Ahead,
like,
go ahead, dog.
Like, damn. But yeah, I think I like it because I think the production on it reminds me so much of LP's kind of style, LP production style, and that's what drew me to that album right away. And it was just so, it was like how he add that synth and jazz at the same time in some of the productions. Man, it was weird, but I liked it. It was
so
cool.
It grew on you then.
Yeah, it grew on me.
Because I know at first you didn't like it.
Yeah, I said it was good, but it didn't move me at first.
So it like, did grow on you.
By the third listen, I was like, man, this damn shit is dope. Like, I liked it. I dug it. What about you?
But let me say real quick on his LP reference. Then I didn't mean to cut you off. Well, you didn't say nothing, so fuck it. I think that's a good point, that the reason I appreciated this album so much is because what Shabazz Palaces is doing is they're doing kind of what Def Jux did when they started out.
Yep.
They challenged everything about hip-hop.
Yep.
They looked at what everyone was doing, and they said, you know what, we're going to flip this shit. Yeah, we're still on some boom-bap shit at the same time, but we're not going to make standard average hip-hop. And I think that's what's so special about this album. This is definitely not ride music. This is, I mean, not for you at least. I would listen to it in my car. But this is not something I would expect someone to throw in their car and ride around jamming.
I disagree with you.
You put this in your car?
Yes. Man, them beats is tight. You know what I'm saying?
I'm like,
look, put it like this. The album, I didn't necessarily like the album because I can't get it, I guess. And I've listened to it 3-4 times now. I can't get it. Yeah. But the production is there. And there was a track I was telling Kent. Oh man, I'm so fucking bad with names. I need to get better with that.
The names on the album are so weird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's no way.
What, Kent? How does the thing go?
You asking me? I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah.
But anyway, the album. You know, say overall. I don't know. I don't know what to say about it. Outside of the fact that I love the production, and I could definitely ride it in the car because when I was listening to it with my Beats by Dre, man, that shit was knocking. It was knocking. I definitely love the production. I like how B said, you know, because you do hear the jazz influences and stuff in there. And then the bass hits hard. I love the production. The production's on point for me. I love the production.
And you know who it is, right?
Mm-mm.
Who produced it? No. You know who is the person behind the album? I think that's the most interesting part of the whole situation. It's fucking Butterfly from Diggable Planets. You didn't pick up on his rhyme style?
But I'm
saying that was a really interesting thing to me because when I first heard their EP, like, I don't know how long ago it was, but I first heard their original EP, when I put it on, I was like, that sounds like dude from Jungle Planet, but it wouldn't really make much sense for him to be doing music like this. And he was calling himself King
Lazaro.
Something Palisier.
Palisier
Lazaro. So I was just like, yeah, I thought that was actually really interesting, but
man, you know.
Took the glasses off.
Damn.
Only the glasses off, had to look away from
it. Shabazz Palace has had to have definitely been another heavily requested review from us. And I didn't understand this shit at all the first time I listened to it. And it was all over the place. So did a little research, and I knew it was the first listen. I knew that's not enough for something that's different. Did a little research about it, and they said, you know what, it's kind of like jazz, Eric Dolphy, Albert Ayler. So, you know, I was talking to C-Town about it yesterday, so I said, you know what I need to do. So I went and pulled out my Eric Dolphy and Albert Ayler albums and listened to it. I think And I really, when I listened to Albert Ayler's Spiritual Unity, I think that was one of the ones I listened to, I kind of understood musically what they were doing with the assortment of different sounds and how they were almost like talking to each other, yet also it was almost like a Dead End Hip Hop conversation, where you had all this stuff that's coming at each other one by one, and where when it gets together, it kind of all makes sense after you break it all the way down. But see, the thing is, so once I understood that, I was like, okay, now I kind of understand a little bit about what this is, and it's definitely challenging hip-hop. And then he told me that it was the guy from Diggable Planets, which I like those guys as well, too. So then I actually listened to, now I was able to actually get into the lyrics. Because I'm a guy, I pick them on the music first, and then I kind of get into more of the lyrics. Then I listened to the lyrics, and the lyrics were actually on point, man. I think it's definitely good. I see why it's receiving as many praises as it has so far, man. And I liked it. But I think the thing is, you know what? I woke up this morning, it was around 6:40 something.
Your damn story, boy, you killed me with that, man.
And I was, because you know what the thing was, I was so disconnected with the album, man. I got up this morning, it was like 6 something, so I was starting to do some work, and I had a plan, because I listened to it like 4 or 5 times this morning, because I wanted to really understand this album. It's kind of like Kendrick Lamar. I really wanted to understand this album and what they were doing, what they were going for, and where could we place them. And you know, even when people and I were coming over, I was still listening to it then, man, because you know what? I knew it was something that I was missing, and I was able to finally put it together. It was like, you know what? He's right. It is almost like alternative hip-hop in a sense, but we need that. We need something new, fresh, mm-hmm. challenging, diverse, instead of the same old norm stuff over and over again. And I think for the most part, then I'm glad that we all, you know, appreciate and dig the album for what it's worth. Even if we are able to just pick out the production or the sound, you know, even we are able to appreciate the whole album as a whole. But I think it's dope, man. I think it's really good, man. I can play this again because it has so many damn different pieces to it. You know what? The first listen, that was one of the, it was the last of 2 tracks. That was one of the very first songs that I really liked that caught my ear from the album, was that particular song with them. And it's 3 something. I don't know who they are. Somebody look it up on their iPhone. But definitely, man, I it's solid, man. It's definitely solid, man. I
like it, man. I mean, it's no really negatives for the album. Just go get the album, copy it, go support some good music, man. If you might not like it, it's a bit like C-Town mentioned, it's very different. It's a different type of hip-hop, you know, hip-hop album that you expect to listen to. So, but just listen to it with open ears, man, and just appreciate good music, man. Appreciate the good production and the rhyme scheme and what else. That's about it. That's all I can say.
If you're a fan of shit like, you know, Lil Wayne, T.I., that kind of stuff, you probably really won't appreciate this album. I mean, let's be real. Probably won't. But if you're a fan of stuff like K the I, if you're a fan of stuff like Antipop Consortium, if you're a fan of stuff like early soul, anything that is esoteric with hip hop, that's really creative and different with hip hop, you'll appreciate an album like this. It's not for everybody, but I think also something to really, really think about is this album is not even on a hip hop label. Like, this is the first hip hop album to be put on Sub Pop.
Really?
And Sub Pop does indie rock. They've always done indie rock, and they're known for that, for doing stuff, you know, Sonic Youth, you know, good albums like that. This is the first hip-hop album for them to sign, because they look at this as, this isn't just a hip-hop album, this is just a good fucking music album. Like, this is something I could put on and paint, this is something I could put on and just chill out. I don't smoke weed, but I could imagine this would probably be a good album to smoke weed to. This is just a really, really good album.
Struggles proceed, you can't lie to yourself. Yourself, you can't lie how it felt. No surprise how the cards getting dealt. That's why.